It's time for one of the highlights in the Songs of Praise calendar as five of the best amateur gospel choirs in the country arrive at Reading Town Hall to raise the roof in song. They've made it through our first round of judging and now they meet for the first time. Welcome to the 2019 Songs of Praise Gospel Choir of the Year. Welcome to the concert hall here in Reading Town Hall for this very special gospel choir competition. I'm YolanDa Brown and I've loved gospel music all my life, and not just as a musician. It's uplifting, it's soul-searching, it's inspirational, and so I'm really looking forward to hearing the choir sing, and I hope you are too. In this first of two special programs, each choir will perform one song, then next week they have a second chance to impress the judges before one of them is crowned the Songs of Praise Gospel Choir of the Year. So let's say hello to our five choirs. All the way from Hull, we have G Choir. From Coventry, we have Nexus ICA Gospel Choir. From Preston, it's One Voice Community Choir. We have Cambridge University Gospel Choir. And finally, from right here, it's Reading Community Gospel Choir. Oh, it's so great to hear so much support here in the hall. All they have to do now is impress our three distinguished judges. And I got angels on my side. Rick Astley became a huge star in 1987 when his hit single, Never Gonna Give You Up, topped charts the world over. 30 years later, he's still packing out arenas and the award-winning artist has just released his greatest hits album. Brenda Edwards grew up singing in her Pentecostal church in Luton and hasn't stopped performing since. She's currently starring in A White Christmas in London's West End, followed by a tour of the musical Sister Act. Our third judge lives and breathes gospel music. Mark De-Lisser is one of the country's top vocal coaches and music arrangers, working on BBC One's This Is My Song and Our Dementia Choir. Please give them a warm welcome. It's time now to hear from our first finalist, G Choir. Apparently the G stands for gospel as well as God. Here's Helen, their musical director.
Here we are at the Humber Bridge. This bridge is so important to us because it connects our members of G Choir from East Yorkshire and Lincolnshire.
We rehearse once a month in this amazing church, St Mary's in Ellerton.
I come about 45 miles each way to choir, but it's once I get here and we start, it's a great stress reliever.
Father, we just thank you for this opportunity to be able to come together tonight, Lord, to bring our sound of worship to you, God.
I've run choirs for many years, but G Choir, we only actually set up a year and a half ago. It feels like everything's really accelerated and it's just such an exciting time for us.
Oh, how marvellous it is.
Helen is really inspirational. She has such a strong faith, but also a strong belief in us.
She can just hear what needs to be done and she can hear if you're making mistakes as well and pick them out.
I feel so passionate about what singing can actually do for people. It's just the most amazing thing to do as a community. But I think it changes so much when you add faith into the mix.
Hallelujah. I can say it's one of those songs that you sing it and actually worship.
It's an absolute favourite of ours as a choir because it's just our opportunity to get with God. It's almost like a door in heaven opens and suddenly we're there and we're with God. It's like he's standing right next to us.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty reigns.
Rick, our first choir, did they set a high standard tonight?
Very, very high standard, yeah. What a way to start the show, because that was pretty amazing. It's quite emotional, actually, so I'm now really, really excited to see the rest of the evening, because that was amazing.
And Brenda, hallelujah means praise the Lord. Did you see this choir praising?
I absolutely did. Well done for that. I particularly loved the light and shade of the soft to the powerful. It really brought me in. I felt really with you worshipping all of you there on stage. So that was wonderful. Thank you.
Brilliant. And Mark, you are a vocal coach by trade. Now, I know you were listening very carefully. What did you think of the vocals with this choir?
There's this thing about gospel that it needs to draw you in. It needs to tell a story. And I think right at the beginning where it was really soft and really breathy, I was like, oh man, this is lovely. This is joyous. And then it exploded into this real kind of all over body worship, praise moment. I actually welled up. And actually what was happening and what was very clear is everybody was worshiping. And I just want to say, well done. That's a great start to the show.
These guys are so amazing. We're such a young choir. We've literally been going a year and a half. And I just think if God's working through the choir like this now, do you know what I mean? What's he going to do? And we're just so pleased to be an instrument for him and just do what we do, and that's praise.
Up next is a choir from one of the most prestigious places of learning in the world. It's the Cambridge University Gospel Choir, and they have not one, but two conductors, Carol and Io.
This is Pembroke College, Cambridge, where our gospel choir meets every Monday during term time.
It's the third oldest college in Cambridge, founded in 1347 by the Countess of Pembroke.
We rehearse in the chapel, which was the first to be designed by Sir Christopher Wren.
Oh, you are here.
I came into Cambridge to start a PhD at the Department of Plant Sciences associated with Newnham College. I realized that there was no gospel choir in the university, and I was really very keen to see one, which led me to set up the Cambridge University Gospel Choir a few months later.
I found out the gospel choir at the Freshers' Fair. I was just walking around looking at all the different societies, and then Carol out of nowhere just saw me and was just like, you.
There's no audition, so anyone who lives in Cambridge or the surrounding area can join.
I think what I would say about gospel music in such an ancient place is that it's a sign of progress, I would say, and development.
It's amazing to see it full of people singing and standing and clapping and dancing, and it really brings new life into the chapel to glorify God, which is ultimately what it was designed for.
So Carol is heavily pregnant. So because of that, I'm stepping in to help conduct We Pray.
I love it because it's simple and straight to the point. People can sort of understand, you know, instantly what it's about. I think it just sends a message to people as, you know, to why prayer is important.
To give up, but then it crossed my mind.
What did you do?
I started to pray.
To who did you pray?
To Jesus Christ.
Why?
Because sometimes prayer is the only way out.
We pray in the morning and we pray in the night, because God's got the power to make everything right. What he did for me, he will do for you. And if you didn't know this, well, now you do.
Well, I saw a valley so deep it was frightening. I put on my trust in the Lord God Almighty.
What did you do?
I started to pray.
To who did you pray?
To Jesus Christ.
Why?
Because sometimes prayer is the only way out.
We pray in the morning and we pray in the night,
thoughts around. I had to get my feet back on solid ground.
What did you do?
I started to pray.
To who did you pray?
To Jesus Christ.
Why?
Because sometimes prayer is the only way out.
We pray.
We pray.
We pray.
Brenda, an a cappella song, which is a real test of a choir.
Yes, it is very, very hard to do a cappella, especially as a choir, because all of your voices have got to come together for diction and everything else. There were a couple of parts in the a cappella where I felt that it seemed a little bit rushed sometimes, but in general, I think that you guys held it together very well. Thank you.
And Mark, did they communicate their faith to you?
There was a level of communication that I really enjoyed. And the balance of the parts, I thought, was spectacular, actually. It was really lovely to hear the basses kind of poking through, which was really nice. But lose yourselves more. You can absolutely let go even more.
And Rick, a choir showing a different side to Cambridge University. Did you enjoy that performance?
Yeah, I enjoyed it a lot, actually. There's a real sense of fun about it. Yeah, I'm loving it. I'm really enjoying the evening, to be honest.
Well, thank you so much, judges, and thank you, Cambridge University Gospel Choir.
I think we did well. We put our all into it, and that's really all I can ask for. He wants us to release a bit more, so the next song we're really going to release. Don't worry.
Up next is One Voice Community Choir. They're from Preston in Lancashire and conducted by husband and wife team Tyndale and Kadria.
Welcome to Preston, home of One Voice Community Choir.
Sometimes you really don't feel like going out, but you drag yourself out, and boy, are you glad that you went to rehearsal that night. You fill yourself with oxygen, you have a really good sing, and then you just go home feeling great. It's just wonderful.
When I was 19, my mum suggested that her and I did something together. I've always enjoyed singing anyway, so I thought I'll go along. Fell in love with it, and 19 years later, we're still doing it together.
Tyndale has been the bedrock of this choir since it began 20 years ago this year.
Back in December, my faith was called upon. I had 3 brain hemorrhages and a stroke.
It was only when we went to the hospital, we were told unless he stabilises within 24 hours, then he might not be around.
When we got the news that Tyndale had suffered the illness, which really meant he was not capable to do any work with us or any of his other choirs at all, and that came as a shock.
We just thought the choir might come to an end.
This is the first rehearsal that Tyndale's done for 8 months with the choir, and I think for choir members that have been, you know, with Tyndale since the choir started, it's going to be quite emotional.
I've come through the lows, through to the high, and this is a part of my miracle. This song says, perfect praise. What more can you ask for?
How excellent, how
Now, Mark, that song, How Excellent, is also known as Perfect Praise. Did this choir convey perfect praise?
100%. There's a real beauty in what you guys have just done there, and I just want to publicly just acknowledge Tyndale for being an incredible witness of your faith in God to these people.
Now, Rick, how did you find their musical performance?
I thought it was really stunning. One of the things that I was looking for tonight was passion, and I felt it, I heard it, and I can actually see it as well, so really great.
And Brenda, did you get a sense of togetherness from that performance?
Absolutely did, and can I just say, I love the layers that you had going on. Goosebumps all over. I was very, very excited by that performance. Thank you.
You guys behind me, you are sound amazing. I love getting through my bit because then I can hear their bit.
From the minute we got on stage, that it was worship.
Him, thank you for being back with us.
Thanks, Tyndale.
So good to have you back.
We have two more choirs to go. Have you got your favourite yet? Well, next up, a student choir from Coventry. It's Nexus Institute of Creative Arts Gospel Choir. And here's Hannah, their conductor.
Welcome to the City of Reconciliation. Here behind me, you can see the Coventry cathedrals, which place faith at the centre of our city, in the same way that our choir places faith at the centre of our singing. Nexus ICA is a college that offers higher education courses in popular music and worship.
We're made up on average of about 140 students per year. So you have vocals, keys, drums, bass, guitar, and then you can train to be a sound engineer as well.
The choir is an essential part in order to sing together, to worship together, kind of what you do at church already, but this time you do it with your friends from college.
So I began as a student here, and to have the opportunity to come back as a staff member, as a lecturer, and be able to direct the choir that I was a part of is just such an amazing opportunity.
We love to call.
As a guitarist, I basically work in shapes, and so remembering words and melodies and harmonies is quite hard. So hopefully, on the day, I'll get them all right, but we'll see.
So we chose Sol's Anthem on a practical level because we really wanted to challenge our choir to tackle an a cappella arrangement. That was something that we hadn't really done before.
It is well.
I'm actually quite nervous about singing the solo, but I'm really honoured that I can sing this and that I'm trusted to carry this weight, the weight of these words.
More than with my words or with a song.
Now, Mark, that song was based on the traditional hymn, It Is Well With My Soul. How did you find that performance?
That was a fabulous, fabulous arrangement. So really, really well done. You guys have some really incredible voices. It felt to me like you were more concentrated on the notes and less on the story. So be mindful of that, please. But you guys have got great voices, so thank you so much for performing that.
Brilliant advice. Now, Rick, this is our youngest choir. Did you like the way that their voices blended?
Absolutely. It started very, very, I'd say, sweet, but it opened up, and it opened up really beautifully, and I really like that contrast.
And Brenda, what did you think of them? A fantastic soloist, right?
Soloist, I felt at peace with you, and you were very calming. That was very well done. Thank you very much.
What an amazing experience to be able to have that platform and that opportunity to sing and declare, you know, peace and being at peace with God. Yeah, it was an amazing, amazing time.
Last to sing is a community gospel choir from right here in Reading, and it's run by Gemma and Nicole.
We're excited to welcome the Gospel Choir of the Year competition to our hometown.
And we've been uniting the Reading community for over 10 years to sing gospel music. So we rehearse at the Park United Reformed Church. We're a very eclectic choir. We've got people from all walks of life. Our age range is from 18-year-olds to 70-something-year-olds. Just want them to be committed and to really enjoy gospel music.
I was looking for something to enhance my life. There were two things that I thought that I really wanted to do. One was sing and the other one was play netball. So I emailed two organisations, the choir got back to me, and I haven't played netball.
Gemma and Nicole, they know and love gospel music, and their passion just oozes off them.
Excellent. Give yourselves a clap.
As a double act, they're brilliant because Gemma will have those really powerful, old spiritual songs, and then Nicole will come and she'll jazz it up with some of the new, more modern stuff.
Stranger is a more contemporary and modern song, and it tells the story about Jesus, a stranger coming into town.
That song summarises everything he's done, and I think we need to spread that good news.
Stop!
Now, Rick, I saw some smiles on your face during that performance. Yeah. Did you like the groove? And what about the soloist?
You know, we're here for the choir, there's no doubt about it. But it is amazing when somebody gets up and does a solo like that as well. And I've been really impressed with all the choirs and all the solo singers tonight. Really great.
It shows on your face, sir.
Yeah,
it shows
absolutely.
On your face. And Brenda, what did you think of the overall blend and balance of the choir?
Well, even though it was a gossipy kind of start, it was a powerful gossip. That message of gossip, do you know the man? If anybody doesn't know the man, they'll want to know the man after that performance.
And that is the job of the choir, so job well done. And Mark, did you enjoy that performance?
The thing about gospel music is you can sing it and it can come through your voice, brilliant. But if it comes through your body, that for me is true gospel. And what you guys did there is you brought me in. If I couldn't hear it, I'd be like, what is going on? What is this thing happening, right? So thank you so much for telling that story and being excellent. Well done.
I was really pleased with what the judges said. They really believe that Jesus has come to town, and that's the whole point of the song. You know, it's all about gossiping. You know, who is this strange man? Who is he and where did he come from? And I think the judges got that, so I'm really pleased.
We are winning this.
Yes. Well, we've heard five inspiring performances from our choirs. Next week, they have one more opportunity to impress the judges. And I think all of our choirs deserve a huge round of applause. Please join us next week for the final and the big decision when we find out who will be lifting the trophy to become the Songs of Praise Gospel Choir of the Year. Now, before we leave you, we have a real treat for all gospel fans. MOBO Award winner Lurine Cato is one of the biggest names in gospel music, and we're delighted that she's here to perform for us. Ladies and gentlemen, with You Revive Me, here's Lurine Cato.
Oh, I will lift up my head. I will worship now. I will say that the Lord.